survivor of a hit and run, February 17th, 2013. I was riding my bicycle with my wife in Griffith Park. I was struck by an individual in a light-colored minivan and dragged nearly a quarter of a mile from the streets of Griffith Park down the Frye Freeway. I'm obviously lucky to have just lost my leg. I should have lost my life. Thankfully, I have found many friends. One of them is Assemblyman Gatto, who's been there literally from the beginning, from the first days when I was in the hospital, Councilman Englinger, and we are now working with LAPD and other individuals on taking effective actions.
Most people believe that one of the worst things that a human can do to another human is to leave somebody on the side of the road to die. And it's time for our laws to reflect our values. And the reason we are here today, of course, is to announce Assembly Bill 47, which would create a yellow alert program in the state of California. My legislation would allow local law enforcement the ability to, when they have a partial plate or a partial description of a hit and run perpetrator, to post that information on emergency alert systems. We have the existing infrastructure. It makes sense for us to use it. And we need to get the message out to people who commit these crimes that if you commit a hit and run, your license plate is going to be broadcast on our freeways. Now, the city of Denver recently implemented an alert system like the one proposed here today. Their apprehension rate ran up from about 20%, which is what we have in Los Angeles, to over 75%. And you think about that, that is a real and meaningful way that this alert system can make a difference in lives for all the families out there seeking justice when their family member gets victimized by a hit and run.
The city of Los Angeles put out a cry for help. We sponsored and put forth a resolution to ask the state to intervene to help, and because we need to do more. If you get into a car accident and you are cowardly enough to leave the scene and you flee and you turn into a coward, you are now committing a crime. We are no longer calling these accidents in the city of Los Angeles. These are crimes, and you are a criminal suspect. And we're going to come after you, and we're going to catch you, and we're going to prosecute you.
Last year, my Assembly Bill 184 extended the statute of limitations to solve hit-and-run accidents. This year, my Assembly Bill 1532 would create a mandatory license suspension for any person who flees the scene of an accident. AB 1532 sends a message: if you commit a hit-and-run, you're going to lose your license, period.
We're so excited to be sitting here with city and state on the same page about the need to make our streets safer for walking and biking and reduce this terrible epidemic. What a statement it makes, where if you hit and run, your name is going to be in lights all across Southern California, and it's not the good kind of fame. So this is such an incredible step forward, and we look forward to continuing the progress that Assemblymember Gatto has made on this important issue.
Many of you here are old enough to remember how attitudes changed with drunk driving. For a while, drunk driving in this country was kind of treated with a pat on the back, and in some cases the police would escort you home. It was treated as something that a lot of people did. But the efforts of certain groups like Mothers Against Drunk Driving in the 1980s really changed society's attitudes. And Damian Kevitt is right. We do need a change in attitudes. And it's our hope that all of these efforts, the public, the legislature and local authorities coming together to work to make sure that our legislation reflects our values, to make sure that the message is sent to the public, that there's going to be tough penalties. But it's also going to take attitudinal changes from people in society to make sure that they don't subject people to this really, really cowardly and heinous act.